In this video, we're going to outline what is required in biological or microscope drawings. So I have a sample here. We'll walk through the first one together, and then I'd like you to try the second one and actually use the biological drawing checklist to assess it on your own. So let's take a look at the requirements for the biological drawing checklist. The first thing that we notice is obviously we have to have the artist name up here. We need the marker's name, and in this case, this is going to be me. And then let's take a look at what is required and how this person did. So first thing for a biological drawing is it must be done on blank paper. In this case, yes, definitely done on blank paper. Is the name and date located in the top right corner? No, the name and date should be somewhere up in here, which it is not. So we cannot give them a mark for that. Is the drawing large, about a quarter of a page minimum? The reason it's large is some of the specimens we're looking at is small. And if you don't make it large on your sheet, it is hard to see the detail. So in this case, yes, it is rather large. Are there appropriate and detailed title above the drawing? Yep, there's definitely a detailed title. It's telling us exactly what is in the image, which is an amoeba. Is the title underlined? Yes, it certainly is. Drawing is made inside a circle. Notice how nice and clear and round the circle is. Trace a circle. Don't freehand it or you will not get that mark. This person does get the mark. Is the drawing done in pencil? It's hard to tell here, but yes, we will give them the mark for being done in pencil. You don't ever use markers or pencil crayons or things like that because the colors that you see on the microscope are because of the stains that are used. It's not actually representative or reflecting the actual color of the object that you're looking at. So we always do it in pencil. It always gives you the chance to go back and change mistakes. Are the lines steady and clear? So in terms of the outside of the cell, is there a clear definitive boundary around what you're looking at? In this case, yes, it is. We can't do sketching because in terms of biology, a cell membrane or a cell wall around the outside of a cell, it is definitively solid. There aren't any breaks in it unless the same cell is damaged. Do they use stippling instead of shading? Now, stippling is this dotting technique. You can't take your pencil and put it sideways and shade in with it. You have to do little dots to show where there are darker regions when you're doing biological drawings. So in this case, yes, this person did an excellent job of the stippling. Even in sections that look pretty much empty, there will be some stippling because it is not completely uniform in terms of texture or color or shading that you see through the microscope. Only relevant and easily seen details are included. So if you look around, only the things that were clearly visible, like there are no air bubbles put in there, they don't put their eyelashes in there. So they'll get their mark for that. Labels are neatly printed. Yes, they will get their mark on that. Labels are located at the right of the diagram. Yep, that's a nice easy mark. Labels are listed in an even column. No, they should be distinctly lined up in a column. So they will not get the mark for that. Label lines do not cross. They don't cross, but they're not exactly as neat as possible. You want to try to make them horizontal. If at all possible. So I will give them the mark for that because the lines don't actually cross, but they're not as neat as they possibly could be, but they did use a ruler, which is important. Total magnification located below the drawing. Yes, this is 100 times. So they would get the mark for that. Overall quality of the drawing. So does it look like it is rushed or does it look like they took their time? Can you distinctly see the different areas that are labeled? In this case, this person would definitely get a 3 for this drawing. So if we go along, out of 18, they lost a mark here, so they're down to 17, and 16 out of 18 for that drawing there. Now, if you wanted to take a look at a second drawing, here is an example of a liver cell that was drawn. I would like you to pause the video, go through the biological checklist and see what score you would give this person, because you will have to peer assess and self-assess some of your own biological drawings, so it's good practice. So pause the video now and see what score this person would get out of 18 on this liver cell drawing. So let's see how your assessment of this drawing compares to what I would give them if it was handed in. So first of all, is done on blank paper? Yes. Name and date? No. So they would have lost a mark here. It is large. appropriate title. Yep, we know it's a liver cell. The title is underlined. The drawing is not made inside a circle, so they'll lose a second mark there. Is it done in pencil? Yes. Clear steady lines? Yes. Stippling used for shading? Not really evident that they used a lot of stippling, but there are no solid colors and there's no solid pencil to fill in coloring, so we'd give them a mark there. The next place they would lose a mark is only relevant and easily seen details. With the microscopes we have, we cannot see the rough ER. You cannot see ribosomes or Golgi apparatus. So don't put down things that you know should be there, but you can't see. So if you can't see it, you cannot put it in your diagram. So be careful. A lot of times, people will refer to images on the internet or in their textbook. And there are a lot more details because they use a lot better microscopes than we have in class. So make sure you only label and draw what you can see in class. But the labels are neatly printed. They're located on the right-hand side. They're in a nice even column, and the lines don't cross, so they get all of those marks. They would lose their last mark here in total magnification. They didn't tell me how much larger this is than real life. Is it 40 times, 100 times, 400 times? That's important. That should have been written at the bottom. And in terms of overall quality, they would have a 3. So if someone were to hand this in, I would give it a 14 out of 18. Okay, let's see how you do with your biological drawings in class.